The earth beneath the surface dust is cold and damp and raw, and holding but the memory of what has gone before can almost be forgiven for remembering the dream of the wall of stones around the homes of the villagers of Eyam. The villagers of Eyam. In August 1665, along the cobbled roads, between the houses dark and high, the carriers with their loads were leaving for the northern towns, the capital and crown, and also leaving far behind the plague of London town. The plague of London town. George Vickers was the tailor to the village life of Eyam, and to his house a case of clothes from London town was seen, to be delivered one fine day in September 65. And never more was Taylor Vickers ever seen alive, ever seen alive. The scars upon his face and chest were many to behold, and lying by his fevered body, now so very cold, the case from London open wide, the clothes all neatly hung, and from the bell upon the church the knell of death was rung, the knell of death was rung. There followed 60 scarred and bleeding, buried in their grave, and Thomas Stanley stood above and told them Jesus saved. But Stanley was a Puritan, an enemy to heed, to Mompesson, the Anglican, who held the rector's creed, who held the rector's creed. The differences between these men, which were so very wide, were shattered by their desperate need and rudely cast aside. The voices of these two were joined, their words were not in vain. They told the villagers of Eyam the plague must be contained, the plague must be contained. The village people took their word and agreed to stay and die. They built a wall around the hamlet, not so very high, but high enough so they would know that though it mean their lives, the plague must stay behind the wall, with children, friends and wives, with children, friends and wives. For 6 long months the wall did stand, and honest to their word, the families died, the friths and the siddles never more were heard. The Thornleys, Hancocks and the Tors were buried in the ground. The Coopers and the Vickers never made another sound, never made another sound. The dawn that rang the final bell left 33 alive from 360 in September 65. The villagers rebuild their lives with those who still remained. The name of Eyam can still be seen. The plague had been contained. The plague had been contained. The villagers rebuilt their lives with those who still remained. The name of Eyam can still be seen. The plague had been contained. The plague had been contained.